exams coming closer and closer and closer. Some of you may be getting very tensed up. Some of you may be saying, it's okay, yaar, I'll deal with it. But in either case, you'll be having a lot of people who will be telling you, study hard, study hard, study more. Actually, I don't believe in that, you know. I don't think studying hard gets you results. I think studying smart gets you results. What do you mean by this thing called study smart? It means being able to know when to study. There are times when you need to study, there are times when you don't need to study. It means to know where to study. Oh my God, it makes so much difference where and how you are studying, you know that. And then comes the techniques. How to study, there are different ways of studying. What suits you should be the one that you should pick up. Once you do that, then you become selective. What to study, when. After you have mastered this, or while you are mastering it, there will be one question that you need to ask yourself, that is, why to study? Why study at all? Is it just to get that stupid extra marks? No, it's much more than that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take you through this process of when to study, where to study, how to study, what to study, and why to study. If you understand these concepts, believe me, you'll not only do much better in your exams, you'll have true learning taking place. What goes in will remain permanently with you. Okay? Best of luck. Let's now talk about how to study. Some people study hard. Some people study smart. Which category do you belong to? You go on studying, you go on mugging, you get up in the morning and you say, I'm going to do nothing but study. You know, you are like that woodcutter who wanted to chop so many trees that he forgot to sharpen the saw. You have to sharpen your mental saw from time to time. Each person is unique. I'm not going to tell you how you're going to study. You are going to find out for yourself. There are some of us who open a book, sit down, read peacefully, and they get it. There are some who are auditory people. You may be the type of person who, when you speak loudly, when you read loudly, it gathers in. Simple. Read one chapter softly, read one chapter loudly. See which one your grasp has been better. See if writing down notes helps you. See if writing down just small bullet points helps you. See if walking up and down, stretching a little bit here and there, and then reading helps you, or just sitting in one place all the time. See if you are the visual type, would you like to highlight the most important definitions, formulae and stuff like that, so that you can go back to that. See if you are the kinesthetic type. I know of students who actually keep a whiteboard or a blackboard in their house, and they take a marker and they start writing down. When they write down, they realize that they are able to study better. So there are different ways of doing it, but you have to find out which is the one which is most suitable to you. There is one very good time proven method for studying, which is called the SQ3RT. SQ3RT, 3 R's. S is survey. Survey the topic, survey the subject, survey the textbook. How many chapters there are, what do they deal with? What are good, what are easy, what are difficult? Do that entire survey. Like how you survey a locality before you decide whether this place is good or not. Then question yourself, why am I studying this? What will I gain out of this? How does this connect to that? How is this chapter connected to that chapter? Ask questions, your curiosity goes up. Then come the 3 R's. Read, revise, review. Read it first, review it, what you've learned, and after a gap, maybe at the end of the day or maybe the next day or after a week's time, revise it. A lot of students who keep complaining that I study, I understand, I comprehend, but when I go for the exams, I forget suddenly. It is because they have not done periodic revision. It may be there in your mind, but you know what happens to the mind? It slowly starts sinking, going lower and lower and lower, like your Facebook account. So what you have to do is keep pushing it up. So what took you 1 hour to study initially when you were trying to understand it, revise it in 5 minutes. It will become fresh in your mind. And the last is test yourself. Why do you think schools give, you know, first preparatory, second preparatory, third preparatory? Because the more you practice, the better you are when you finally face the exams. So why wait for the school to give all those preps and this and that? Do your own testing. Give yourself a half an hour test. Give yourself a 1 hour test. I have read this chapter, now close it and write down all that I remember about that thing. Ask yourself certain questions and reply to that. Okay? Now let me give you one very nice technique, which is a time proven thing. It's called mind mapping. Take a subject. Let's say you are not very fond of history. You are forcing yourself to read it. Take a piece of KG cardboard or something, sheet of paper. Start writing like this with a pencil. Why with a pencil? Because if there is a need, you can rub it out and redo the whole thing as and when required. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to study history, right? So I am going to divide history into the sections. Let's say the sections are old history, medieval history. Don't ask me if this is correct or not. I also don't know much about history, okay? Anyway, supposing these are the sections. So I divide them into four sections. Then you know what I do? I take one of them. I take post-independence history. So I say independence struggle. Then I say some, emergency period. Then I say something else. So I divide it again into three or four parts. Once I've done that, ask yourself, how much do I know about this? One means I know everything. Two means I know something. Three means I know nothing. Now this one was a little interesting. So I know quite a bit, number one. This one, I know a little bit, but I'm not very sure. Two, this has gone over my head, number three. Once you mark this off, whenever you sit down to study, start with reading number three. Wherever it comes, even if it's in the middle of a chapter or paragraph, read this when your mind is fresh. Then spend shorter time doing this. Then just spend 2 or 3 minutes revising this. Will you listen to harmony? So every time this happens, you keep doing this. And every time you feel that you are learning something, rub this three, make it two. Rub this two, make it one. As your exam comes closer, you'll develop that confidence that my threes are becoming twos and my twos are becoming ones. Your confidence goes up and you know as the time keeps getting shorter and shorter, what should I spend time and study on? Once you do that, you will not have that examination stress. You will be able to happily face the exams. Best of luck.